Some very hairy mice are bringing us another step closer to unlocking a way to regenerate a full head of hair.
Did somebody say a pun?
About 50% of men and 25% of women experience at least partial hair loss by the age of 50, whether due to age or medical treatments or disease.
Current options for those looking to reverse this loss include things like medications that may slow hair loss and transplants from hair follicles elsewhere on the body.
But neither have the often desired effect of restoring a thick and full volume of hair. Researchers have been optimizing techniques for culturing hair follicle germs in a dish for years.
There are two key types of cells that help hair follicles develop before we're born. There's epithelial cells that help us create skin, and mesenchymal cells that help us create a variety of connective tissue. So researchers copied this strategy from the embryo into the lab, and they got hair follicles to grow.
Although these techniques were never high yield enough to produce the amount of follicles needed to restore a full head of hair to its previously luxurious glory until now.
Recently, Japanese researchers made improvements to this protocol and then designed a special oxygen-permeable mini-chip to scale up the farming of follicles, growing up to about 5,000 at once.
The chip isn't like a computer chip, though. It's a tiny polymer structure with little wells in it. They grow the follicles, they add collagen mesh layers for easy handling, and they transplant it right to the head, where hopefully it takes hold and grows like normal hair.
They showed that transplanting these follicles onto immunodeficient mice led to lots of new hairs being formed within just 18 days.
That's pretty quick. They could easily transfer cells from their chip to a collagen matrix for uniform transplant, with follicles nice and evenly spaced out, which would make for practical harvesting when it comes time to transplant cells grown with these chips onto humans.
And while these engineers made big progress in the scale-up and efficiency of growing hair follicles on a chip, their tests were all done with immunodeficient mice.
Not the best. It's not always a great idea, though, to suppress a human's immune system. It leaves us vulnerable to infections. So each patient would need their own personal source of hair follicles before we could make this a reality. Fortunately, hair follicles do contain stem cells capable of regenerating new hairs, among other cells.
Meaning that perhaps in the future, instead of transplanting follicles from another part of the body, scientists can take a few follicles from a patient, expand them in culture, then transplant way more back onto your bald spot.
Savage. For those eagerly waiting solutions, don't worry, they're coming for us. Keep putting sunscreen on the back of your head, everyone.
We have the machinery, scientists just need a little more time to figure out the cells that'll grow in them.
Before you go, everybody, this is Sam.
Hi.
Sam is going to be on the channel more often from now on. She's amazing. She studies neurobiology. I predict, like hair, she's going to grow on you.
That is an excellent, horrible pun. Hi, everyone. I'm super excited, and apparently I'll need to up my pun game.
No, your puns are great. You can also find Sam over on Instagram.
Yep, I'm at science.sam, and I talk about my work in neuroscience and other science communication topics all the time.
Thanks for watching. Did you know that we shared our DNA with Neanderthals?
And they shared it with us too, if you know what we mean. Watch this video to learn more. And did you know that there's a special word for something that produces hair? It's called trichogenic, and insects and other arthropods have these types of cells too. Thanks again for watching Seeker.